Hello lovelies, how are you guys doing? Do let us know in the comment section below. So in today's lesson, you are going to learn about correlative conjunction. What actually are correlative conjunction? Basically, as we know, conjunction join words, clauses, phrases and sentences. But what are actually correlative ones? Let's get into the video. The lesson will be guided by Shilajit Chatterjee.
Conjunctions are a part of speech that are used as joining words. Conjunctions are words that link other words like I like tea and coffee, two sentences together, Rahul is good but his brother is bad. So and but both are conjunctions in these sentences. Abdul is intelligent but his friend is dull. So here we have the examples of how conjunctions are joining other words like tea and coffee and two sentences. Now let us look at how conjunctions are joining two different clauses. He is the man who earns honestly and whose son spends all. Conjunctions also join phrases. The sun rises in the east and sets in the west. So these are all examples of how conjunctions are used as linking words to join other words, two sentences, clauses as well as phrases. So here is another example. So here you can see how the conjunction when is joining two different clauses. Sara will play and her homework is done. Here also the conjunction and is joining two different phrases, people's ignorance and population explosion. Conjunctions are mainly of three types: coordinating conjunctions, subordinating conjunctions and correlative conjunctions. In this video I am going to focus only on the correlative conjunctions or the correlatives. Correlative conjunctions are used in the form of pair of words, or in other words, correlative conjunctions are always used together in a sentence. They form a pair. For example, I'll have both an ice cream and a milkshake. Here the correlative conjunction pair both and are used together in this sentence to make complete sense. Correlative conjunctions connects words of equal syntactic importance. So correlative conjunction pair joins a noun or a pronoun with another noun or a pronoun, joins a verb with another verb, joins an adjective with another adjective, and so on. So let us look at a few examples. Either you or your friend has done it. Here the correlative conjunction pair either or is being used. In this example, she can neither sing nor dance. Here the correlative conjunction pair neither nor is being used together. Pritha is not only intelligent but also laborious. Here the correlative conjunction pair not only but also is being used. If we say both Ram and Shyam have passed the examination, here we can see that the conjunction pair both and is being used. Both is being followed by a noun and is also being followed by a noun. So both Ram and Shyam have passed the examination. Here we can see that the conjunction pair is following a noun. So similarly, in this example, she can neither sing nor dance. The conjunction pair neither and nor both are following a verb. The one part of the conjunction pair is following the verb sing. Another part of the conjunction pair is following the verb dance. Similarly, here we can see that the conjunction pair not only but also is joining one adjective with another adjective. Here not only is being followed by the adjective intelligent, and but also is being followed by the adjective laborious. Here I have mentioned some of the commonly used correlative conjunction pairs, both and, either or, neither nor, not only but also, whether not, rather than. And also I have given some examples to show how these conjunction pairs are used in sentences. So these are some of the commonly used correlative conjunction pairs. There are also other correlative conjunction pairs, but these are some of the most commonly used conjunction pairs. One more thing which needs to be mentioned over here is that when you are using these paired conjunctions, make sure that the correct parts are being used together. Like, you cannot use both and or together as a conjunction pair in a sentence. Neither can you use either and together as a pair of correlative conjunction in a sentence. So both and has to come together in the sentence. Similarly, both these parts of the conjunction pairs always has to come together in a sentence. Only then will they make complete sense. So there are certain rules which need to be followed when using correlative conjunctions in a sentence. Number one rule says that when there are two singular subjects in a sentence, that is, for example, in this sentence, Rahul and David both are singular subjects, so the verb following them also has to be a singular verb. In the next example, neither the students nor the teachers were present at the candlelight march. Here we can see that students is a plural subject as well as teachers is also a plural subject. So when both the subjects used in the sentence are plural subjects, the verb following them will have to be a plural verb while you are using correlative conjunction pairs. When we are using the correlative conjunction pair both and in a sentence, then even though the subjects used in the sentence may be singular subjects, the verb following them can be a plural verb. Here, the movie and the play both are singular subjects, yet they are being followed by a plural verb. So this is an interesting thing to be noted while using the correlative conjunction pair both and. Now when there is a singular subject as well as a plural subject in the sentence, what kind of verb are we going to use? In this case, the verb is going to agree with the subject that is closest to it. So in this example, kids is a plural subject, hence the verb like is also a plural verb because the verb is closest to the plural subject. Okay, so if the verb is closest to the plural subject, it has to be a plural verb, and if the verb was followed by a singular subject, the verb would have been a singular verb. This is another rule which needs to be followed while using correlative conjunction pairs. Now in this example, neither the city councillors nor the mayor has addressed the recent rise in street crimes. The verb that is used in this sentence is a singular verb, that is, has is a singular verb. Now why is a singular verb used in this sentence? Because the verb is preceded by a singular subject. In the previous example, the verb was preceded by a plural subject, hence the verb was a plural one. So when there are two kinds of subjects in a sentence, one is singular and the other is a plural subject, the verb following them will agree with the subject which is closest to it, which is closest to it. Now let us look at the rules of pronouns when a pair of correlative conjunction is used in a sentence. For example, here neither Rima nor her sister bought her costume. Here there are two singular subjects, hence the pronoun which is used will be singular. Her is a singular pronoun. So when there are two singular subjects, the pronoun used will be singular. However, when there are two plural subjects, the pronoun used will be plural. There is a plural pronoun and the subjects are also plural. So both the subjects are plural, so the pronoun will also be plural when we are using these correlative conjunction pairs. Now what happens when one of the subjects is singular and the other subject is plural? Similarly, like I said before, while describing the rules about the nouns, here also the same rule will follow. That is, the pronoun will agree with the subject which is closest to it. Here we have used a plural pronoun. Why? Because the subject which is closest to it is also a plural subject. So the pronoun will agree with the plural subject over here. So the pronoun will agree with the subject which is closest to it. So these are some very important rules when we are using correlative conjunctions. Another important rule which needs to be followed while using correlative conjunctions in a sentence is the rule of the parallel structure. So let us look at what this rule says. When using one of the correlative conjunction pair, example both and, neither nor, either or, not only but also, etc. in a sentence, we have to be sure to use the same part of speech, example noun, verb, adjective, or the same grammatical structure, phrase or clause after each part of the correlative conjunction pair that we are using in the sentence. Now, what does this mean? In this example, both Ravi and Ashish will come to our house. Here, the correlative conjunction pair both and is used, and each part of the correlative conjunction pair is being followed by a noun. Here, Ravi is a noun and it is preceded by one of the part of the correlative conjunction both and Ashish is also a noun which is followed by another part of that correlative conjunction pair. Similarly, in the next example, we were told either cut back on expenses or find more money. Here, the correlative conjunction pair either or is being used. One part of that pair is followed by the verb cut. Another part is also followed by a verb. Hence, it is following the rule of the parallel structure. In another example, I did this both for you and for him. The correlative conjunction pair both and is being used over here, and one part of that pair is followed by the preposition for and the other part is also followed by a preposition. Hence, this sentence is also following the rule of the parallel structure in a sentence. Let us look at another example. Not only is he rich but also intelligent. So this sentence is not a correct sentence. Rather, the sentence should be structured in this manner. He is not only rich but also intelligent. Now why is this the correct sentence? Because here the correlative conjunction pair not only but also is being used, and one part of that pair not only is being followed by an adjective rich and the other part is also being followed by an adjective intelligent. So both parts of this pair not only but also are being followed by adjectives. Hence this sentence, he is not only rich but also intelligent is following the rule of the parallel structure. Hence, this is the correct sentence and not the above one.
Was it helpful? If yes, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe our channel and hit the notification bell button for more such interesting videos. We will be back shortly. Till then, bye.